I don't know if you knew this yet, Rob, because this was, I believe this was breaking today, right? So I don't know if you know this yet, but did you know Caroline Bryant died?
You know what? I found out in my stream because Torian broke the news.
Ah, okay. Yeah. She passed away at 88 years old, you know? And I see a lot of people online, you know, they're upset at the fact that she passed away without, you know, justice being served. You know what I mean? She was able to escape and elude justice for all these decades, you know, despite the fact that it's a very well-known fact. You know what I'm saying? That, you know, she lied on Emmett Till.
Well, she didn't escape and elude justice. She didn't escape and elude justice. American justice worked for her.
Boom.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's one of the reasons too, like, why I think we got to start like calling things exactly how they are. Like the Carolyn Bryant situation is a situation where the justice system worked the way it was set up to work. When you sit here and let politicians lie and you become a part of the lie, that's one of the ways where people can find themselves programming themselves and becoming confused. This wasn't a failure of justice. This is what white preservative justice is supposed to look like. And we see it.
Literally the face on the screen right now. You're looking at it. Mm-hmm. Now, I agree. That's actually the proper way to put it. You know, and that's why language matters. When you put it like that, you know, it speaks volumes and brings a brighter light to the situation as it pertains to the justice system work exactly how it was designed to. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Yeah. It worked how it was designed to back then when her husband and brother-in-law got off, right? Right. And it worked and it's continued to operate in the same fashion up until 2023. So from 1955 to 2023, the justice system hadn't changed much because the whole family was able to get off, you know, despite the fact that, you know, over the last 2 years, you know, black folks have been making a lot of noise over the last 2 years concerning her whereabouts. They knew where she was. They protesting. They were going to like the DA's office. Like black folks was actually really doing their thing because the mainstream media wasn't covering it like that. You know what I'm saying? But on the grassroots, black folks was actually like holding it down, like really trying to get her prosecuted. You know, but they just wouldn't do it.
Right.
Just wouldn't do it. At the end of the day, you know, just like, no, it's not happening. You know, what did he say? No one involved with Emmett Till murder went to their graves scathed. No, they all went to their grave, you know.
And that's evidence that the justice system works. So if we know that the justice system works, then that means that it's not broken. So if it's not broken, why would they ever fix it? So any talks of any kind of tweaking or anything like that to the criminal justice system is false propaganda. It's never gonna happen. This kind of situation right here is exactly what the American justice system is set up to do. It's set up to facilitate no consequences for white people harming black people and being allowed to live their natural life all the way through without harm. And that's exactly what it did for Carolyn Bryant. The justice system worked here.
Absolutely. Absolutely, 100% work, you know, and it's going to continue to work for the foreseeable future. You know, I don't see it changing anytime soon, you know, because even once again with this news breaks, Caroline Bryant's dead. And by the way, CNN played Don Lemon for trying to like stand up for black history. You know, they definitely not going to run no story on this telling you about how wrong this is that, you know, the system worked for her. They're not going to do that. You know, we're not seeing it yet. We're not going to see it moving forward. This would just be something that's swept under the rug. You know, for as much as like the left and, you know, the Democratic News Network, which is CNN, MSNBC, you know, state sanctioned media, with as much as they love to, you know, for lack of better words, play the race card. You know what I'm saying? You know, they like to do that, you know, and get black folks all in our feelings so that we can run to the polls and vote blue no matter who. They really do a good job in picking and choosing what they want to, you know, play the race card on, right? Well, and when it comes to Carolyn Bryant, they last 2 years when Brothers was on it, you know, and pressing the line to get her prosecuted, mainstream was silent. They were silent. They were silent. And what they don't want as well, they don't want brothers leading the charge. That's why one of the main reasons why they were silent about it, because brothers was leading the charge to get her prosecuted, putting their foot, you know, putting the feet, the people's feet to the fire over there. And they don't like that. You know, if BLM's not behind it, then they're not going to speak on it. You know what I mean?
Right. And that's because BLM is paid opposition.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
You know what I'm saying? But this also shows the important part that the media plays in the court of public opinion. If they don't want something getting into court, they're going to use the media to silence the story. You see, the media can be used to silence, and the media can also be used to bring attention to something. This is a case right here where the media was used to silence the story by not saying anything about it.